happy, the job you do.
Yes.
Are you fulfilled? Are you fulfilled with what you do on a daily basis? If tonight is going to be the end of the road for you, you look back. Would you say yes? Or would you wish that just maybe, you did something different? Adam Contest Chair, fellow Toastmasters, welcome guests. I bring to us today the gospel, the good news of entrepreneurship. 100 years ago, the United States of America and the United Kingdom had major economic crisis. They struggled to compete with other industrialized nations. There was a lack in the land. Not a lack of natural resources, not a lack of oil and gas, no, not a lack of gold or silver, not a lack of people, a lack of obedient factory workers. So a group of men and women got together and set up an education system that would solve that problem. They taught children how to grow up, go to school, graduate from school, get a job, hold that job for 40 years, retire and spend the rest of their days on pensions. That system of education taught kids to sit in a straight line, spend their days responding to a single bell. That bell told them when to sleep and when to wake up and when to eat and when to read and when to write. Fast forward 100 years on, the United States of America and the United Kingdom are experiencing economic problems. The government said to us that the solution to that problem would be creating more jobs. They've been trying to do that since 2008, and we are still in the middle of a recession. Now, I stand here to tell us today that the solution to the problem is increasing the number of entrepreneurs. Who is an entrepreneur? An entrepreneur is that man or that woman, that boy or girl, that person who seizes the initiative to make the most of an opportunity. Very often, that opportunity is a gap in the marketplace or a solution to a problem. No wonder philosophers say that your life is the solution to someone else's problem. No wonder they say that your life is the answer to someone else's question. Today, I will share with us 5 essential principles to becoming a successful entrepreneur. Number one, you need to find your zone of genius. What is your zone of genius? Your zone of genius is the intersection of your passion and your skill set. Why do you need passion? The road to success is very rocky, and you need passion to fuel the perseverance required for the long haul. Number two, you need to identify your ideal customer, your avatar. Where do they go to? Where do they congregate? You need to find them and you need to begin to speak to them. Look to serve them because it's becoming a person of value that you become a person of success. Number three, you need to niche. Don't try talking to everyone. When you speak to everyone, you speak to no one. Find your avatar. Go to the congregation of your ideal customers and continue speaking to them. Go one inch wide and 1 mile deep. That is where your success is. Number four, you need thriving relationships. You need people, like minds, who are going in the same direction as you. When I grow up, I'd like to be a motivational speaker. I would find a family of public speakers, a family of speakers like the Toastmasters. And within that community, I'll find a mastermind, which is what I get from being a member of London Corinthians, my accountability partners. And also you need a mentor who will take you who has been there before you, who is more successful in Batita, and the person who holds you by the hand and take you on that journey. Now, having received the five principles, I challenge you to start a business and put your name on it. Sing a song and do something and put your name on it. In closing, we'll have a record. Number one, remember, find your zone of genius. Number two, find your ideal customers. Number three, remember to niche. Number four, you need thriving relationships because you are the average of the five people you spend your most time with. And number five, you need, remember, number five, a positive mindset. That is the bee that says, I love a lot of Chinese bamboo. It grows 40 feet in 6 weeks, but for five, the first 5 years you need to water it and tend it. That's the bee that says that I'll fly, I'll come to fly at my dreams. And if the storms of life beat me from right to left or from top to bottom, I will begin to run very fast at my dreams. And if my muscles ache, I realize I can't run anymore, I begin to walk. And when I do that, I put a bit of swag to it. Because it's okay to go slowly sometimes. And if my legs are so weak to carry me, just do this. Go down on the horse and begin to crawl through the rain. You need to continue going forward because winning is in going forward. And achieving is in going forward. And success is in going forward. Remember. 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 You can never, ever fail.